Hello everyone, this is Petko Aleksandrov and I continue with a quick overview of the Expert Advisor Studio, which is the strategy builder I am using the most at the moment for the last 2 years and something. And I see with the many reviews I get from the students and the traders that take my courses that EA Studio is very suitable for beginners as well, easier to learn compared to Forex Strategy Builder. So if you want to use two of them, the EA Studio and the FSB, I would suggest you go first with EA Studio and then go with FSB Pro, and it will be easier, because personally I did it the other way around. It was FSB Pro that I first started with, because at this time EA Studio was not yet developed, and honestly it was harder for me to start with it compared to EA Studio. If you start from scratch, definitely EA Studio will be easier for you. And the two softwares are different. I'm not going into details about the difference of the two, but EA Studio has some unique tools that are not available in FSB, and at the same time FSB has some features that are not available in EA Studio. So when I combine them, I find the best results, but that's personally for me. And if you want to start with EA Studio, you can check out the free course that we have on the homepage. And now I will go through it very quickly so you'll have an idea how we use it and you will know what to do. There is 15 days free trial as well, which I would suggest you to go for, because it's absolutely free. And you can export as many expert advisors, test them, see how it's working. It's a great experience for every algo trader. Okay, so the first thing we have, this is the generator. Okay, the generator is the smart tool behind the software which produces strategies based on the historical data. Okay, I already talked about the historical data. I showed you the Forex historical data app, and we have the premium data which comes from the historical data app automatically. Okay, it is uploaded in EA Studio automatically, so I don't need to download it. It's right here. What I do after that is I just make the data work for my broker, and I will show you that in the next lecture. So after that, what I do is I select the symbol, the period. Let's say I want to create strategies for euro dollar on M15, and then I will go to strategy properties, and here we have the option to select how many lots we want to trade. Are we going to use stop loss or take profit? Are we going to set any criteria for the generator or not? And for how long time it will be working? This is the working minutes. As well, we can select some preset indicators, and then we have the acceptance criteria. So if I uncheck those two, I just want to show you very quickly how the generator works. Immediately it calculates some strategies. Here they are, you can see what is the speed, and I already have balance chart for a nice strategy. Okay, all of these strategies, they go into the collection, and from here I can choose the ones that I want to trade with. If I click on the refresh button, they will just refresh, because all the time the generator is generating strategies. Now, as you can see, not all of the strategies look good, okay? You can see what equity lines I have. These are not the strategies that I wanna trade. I just wanted to show you that even if it didn't do anything, the generator will show me strategies, but we have some criterias, and this is actually the acceptance criteria. I didn't use it, and in the next lecture I will show you how I'm using it, but with simple words, this is from where we can predefine, for example, how much of a minimum net profit we want, or how many count of trades we require as a minimum. And the generator will show us strategies only that fulfill this acceptance criteria. Okay, so I will not see a bunch of strategies here that don't look good. Even at the moment, I have some decent strategies. For example, this one over here, you can see what a nice equity line it has. It has two entry indicators, one exit. But what I was saying is that when we use the acceptance criteria, we filter the strategies even before they were generated and shown in the collection. Okay, after we have the strategies, you can do a few things. One is you can select the strategies you want to use from performance filters. So basically from here, I do one more time filtering the strategies. Let's say that I want to see strategies that did minimum of $2,000 as a profit, and you will see that just five of the strategies did over $2,000 of a profit for the period that we have. Or what I can do is I can just go through the strategies and I can select which ones I want to trade just looking from the equity line. And I have selected one of the strategies randomly. You see that I have three entry indicators and one exit indicator, okay? This strategy doesn't use stop loss or take profit because this is how I selected to run the generator just for demonstrational purpose in this lecture. Okay, from here I have a lot of options. I can optimize the strategy, which means that I will look for better parameters. Let me just click on the start without setting anything, and you'll see that I have actually a better strategy with different parameters. Or in other words, the EI Studio finds which are the most appropriate parameters for that strategy, and you can see that the equity line improved a lot. However, this option is also available in MetaTrader. We have Optimizer there. It works much slower and it's not that reliable as EI Studio. And I would go always for EI Studio if I have to do optimization. And if I want to use the last parameters that it found, I will just click on this green edit button, and here is the same strategy, but the indicators, they have different parameters. Now, optimizing the strategy is a little bit risky because we can over optimize it, or in other words, we will just find the best parameters for that period of time, which might not work in the future. And in the next lectures, I will talk more about that because that's super important. Just wanted to let you know what the optimizer is. We have Normalizer as well, which is a unique tool in EI Studio. You cannot find it anywhere else at the moment, I can assure you that. I will just click on start. I don't know if it will be able to do it right now, but basically it will try to remove useless indicators or to reduce the parameters. And right now it didn't do any changes. I didn't set up any different settings. And as I've said, I will talk more about it later. The walk forward is a little bit of more advanced tool. I will just click on start and I will show you what's the idea. Here we check if the strategy was over optimized. Basically how it works, it divides the whole back tested period in a few segments. It does optimization for one segment and then it tests the strategy for the next segment. After that, it includes the new period, does optimization again, and again simulates trading. This is why it's called walk forward. Step by step, it checks if the strategy was over optimized. And because I use the optimizer, it's very likely that the strategy will be over optimized. And I will just stop it now because, as I said, it's more advanced topic and it requires a lot of explanations. I have a lot of free videos about it as well. Then we have the Monte Carlo multi-market and out of sample tools, which are robustness tools, okay? This means that these tools are not changing the strategy like the optimizer, normalizer, and walk forward, but they just check if the strategy is robust enough to perform profitably in the future. For example, This strategy that I picked randomly without any settings one more time is very likely to fail. I will click on start and let's see how many tests will be validated. Actually, it's doing pretty good. Yep, absolutely. 20 out of the 20 are validated. So what the Monte Carlo did in this case, it messed a little bit the historical data. It checked with different spread, slippage. Also, it tried to break the strategy, skipping position entry and skipping position exits. And as well, we have a few more options. And actually, I used the most the last two options. I will tell you why a little bit later in the course. But basically, here the idea is that we don't want to see many backtests to fail. Okay, it does variety of different backtests with different parameters, different spread. And if the strategy is robust, it just doesn't fail, like what happened right now. So we can depend on that strategy. The multi-market checks if this strategy is profitable on other markets. So I have here, for example, Brent crude oil, which obviously it's not Forex. So we'll just switch to some currency pairs and anything. Okay, I will just click on start and you will see how this strategy works for any other market that it chooses. Now, while it's calculating them, I want to make something clear for the multi-market from the beginning. If the other markets are losing or the strategy loses on the other currency pairs, this doesn't necessarily mean that it's a losing strategy, okay? Because initially it was created for euro dollar and not for the rest. But if the strategy is profitable on 4 out of 5 or 3 out of 5, then this is great, right? Because this way you will feel more comfortable using it when you know that it's a strategy that would work on other currency pairs as well. Right, and then we have the out of sample monitor, which is very useful. This is a preferable method for many of the traders to test the strategies, and it helps me to avoid demo testing, and it gives a lot of statistics. But what's the idea of the out of sample? Okay, it's a lot of information I've brought to you in this lecture if you are looking at a strategy builder for the first time, but just wanted to give you an idea what are the different tools. In the next lectures I will go through those in more details. But the out of sample does something very, very simple. It divides the whole back tested period in two zones. The white zone is the in sample part and the green zone is the out of sample part. And in this case, we have 30% out of sample. I can change it to 20, for example. So if we use 20% out of sample, that would mean that the generator will use these 80% to generate strategies, and then it will simulate trading for the last 20%, which will be very similar if we have placed that strategy on a demo account. And in this case, the out of sample starts from the 4th of February 2020. And until the moment, today is the 20th of November. This is a lot of testing that I would have wasted on demo accounts to see if the strategy was profitable or not. And you can see that it was profitable with $601. In this case, okay, basically this is what it means. This is the out of sample, and in the next lectures I will show you how I'm using it. It's very useful. And as well, in the next lecture I will show you what is the reactor, because this is the tool that made EA Studio the best software out there. Okay, the reactor does everything I showed to you absolutely automatically. Okay, I don't need to go through all of these steps manually anymore. It was like that before, but then they created the reactor from Forex software company. This is the company that has developed EA Studio, and once we had the reactor, it was a game changer. Everything happens automatically. And in the next lecture I will show you how I use it and how you can test it as well with the free trial. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you right away in the next video. Cheers.